Like a dog chewing on a bone, I just can't stop gnawing on L.A. Noire. That's right, everyone, we're going to be doing this again. This is the last... Oh, whoops, that's not what I want to do. This is the absolute last time I will be discussing technical issues once again, everyone. I have broken down. I've given up. The game has beaten me. I cannot figure out a way to make it run at 30 frames per second and 1080p. So, we're going to go old school. Not quite as old school as this game is, but we will go a little bit old school, and we will be recording at 720p. I hope y'all don't mind, but it's the only way to make sure this game runs at a smooth 30 frames per second. And it also allowed me to increase the graphics quality of the game up to max, so that's something. I think the game just doesn't like 1080p specifically. I don't think it was made to do it. Anyway, this mission that we're going to be doing is the Consul's car. Yeah, it's very dramatic.
Okay, we're gonna keep this short. I'm already late for the DA. First up, Phelps, Bukowski. We got a report of a brand new Packard abandoned in an empty lot off 2nd Street between Olive and Grand. PR is one Oswald Jacobs says the vehicle was dumped in his backyard. There's a patrolman on site. Get down there and see what you can turn up. Any questions? Good. Get going.
All right. So this mission.
Better go earn our pathetic wages.
Yeah. Cops don't get paid anything.
Rimsky, O'Halloran. Intelligence has information on a stolen car racket.
An abandoned vehicle. We catch all the good ones, huh, Phelps?
Sounds like there's more to it than that. Nobody dumps a shiny new Packard unless they borrowed it without asking.
You don't say. You're on fire today, Einstein.
Very funny.
I know, it's amazing.
Come on, my intense protege. Let's go save the world.
We sure will. So, this is actually one of the first DLC missions. In fact, I think it was the first DLC mission. Come on, Bukowski, we ain't got all day. Actually came packaged with the game, at least the version of the game I bought, on the PS3. However, from what I understand, this game is actually completely...
Did you hear about Adrian?
Oh.
Brought to Seattle, threw him out. Wife says she's gonna take him back.
Women generally show more compassion. What are you talking about? Adrian dumped on her, he was humping the secretary. Margaret should show some pride.
Pride comes before a fall, Bukowski. Talking from experience.
I completely missed my turn off listening to that gripping conversation. However, as I was saying, this game is not on the Xbox, as far as I know. You cannot purchase this case on the Xbox version. It's only on the complete version of the game, the PS3 or the PS3 or PC. There, I said it. Good. I know words and things and how to speak.
Phelps, traffic.
I'm Officer Houlihan. Car's down the alleyway, detectives.
We got a call about an abandoned vehicle?
Yes, sir. The car has flags. Might be some kind of diplomatic vehicle.
Has anyone touched this vehicle since you arrived?
No. And that Jacobs bird over there was on station before I got here.
We'll talk with him in a moment. Give us some time to look the place over.
Sure, take your time. He's a sore-headed old son of a bitch, anyway.
Yeah. The way he's sitting there and writing his little notebook, it kind of strikes me as the kind of person who just waits for something to be going wrong so he can make sure that everybody knows about it and he can tell everyone how bad it is. Alright, so...
It's owned by the Argentinian embassy.
That's what I was just about to say, Cole. Yeah, apparently this is in fact a diplomatic vehicle for for the Argentinian embassy. In fact, if you're a smarter person than I am, you would just know immediately that's the flag for that country.
You must have taken the flag as a souvenir. Can't have any street value.
Indeed, so our first clues indicate that I've already looked. Oh yeah, forgot about that. No license plates. So the first indication is that this was not merely just a theft of the car, but also to kind of prove a point about something.
Stealing the wheels is for amateurs. The car ring would have stripped it in a warehouse.
Yep, Kofup's been on the desk only a couple weeks, and he is already an expert of everything automotive. He's a very brilliant officer. It's not empty, there's a toolbox right there. You are lying to me, Cole. I don't appreciate that. Oh, I'm glad this guy's taking pictures of that baseball. Good job. You're on the case, sir. Oh, and this cup here. This is vital. This smashed cup is irrelevant. Vital information. No, Cole. This guy is over here snapping pictures of this stuff. It's vital to the case. It's important. See these beer bottles over here? You don't know it yet, man, but they're the key to crack in this case. Also,
combination wrench. Must have used it to remove the wheel lugs.
On top of that, we also now have a new location to find. The Dewey Brothers Automotive Car Dealership. Automotive Car Dealership, whatever. I turned off the...
Better see what this Jacobs guy has to say. The car was dumped in his backyard, after all.
Well, I think looking at it like this, it's kind of everyone's backyard. Yeah, back in the good old days when you could be a casual racist and everyone showed their backyard.
Oswald Jacobs?
That's right.
What exactly happened here, Mr. Jacobs?
Last night, I was looking out of my window. I like to keep an eye on what's going on.
I can understand that.
You see this empty lot? Damn kids play stickball here. Always breaking my windows. Always asking for their ball back.
Can we get back to the car, Mr. Jacobs?
Don't be impatient, Sonny. Anyways, last night I see this brand spanking new Packard up on bricks.
Yeah, you can tell he's really enjoying himself with this situation. He's really happy with everything going on. Very nice. He feels very important right now.
Did you see who stole the Packard?
Hell yes, I did. I saw three goddamn Mexicans going to work on it.
Slightly racist, sir. I'm sure all brown people are Mexican to you, but I think he's telling the truth here.
Can you tell us what they were doing?
Using the headlights of an old Ford so they could strip the thing. I yelled out to them, "I'll call the cops." So they loaded up their car and drove off, tooting and hollering and yelling obscenities at me in Mexican.
You speak Spanish, sir?
No, I do not.
He doesn't speak it, but pretty sure. Tone of voice, you can kind of assume.
After the Mexicans left, you didn't go anywhere near the car?
After I scared them off? No, I didn't go anywhere near that car.
Okay. I like the look on Cole Phelps' face, like, on there, like, seriously, dude, are you trying to bullshit me here? Like, look at this guy's face. He is not a bullshitter. Well, I think he is a bullshitter, but not about... He's not very good at it.
You went out to the car. Once they were gone, you had to take a look for yourself.
I was curious. Ain't a law against that. So what if I took a look around that car? You can't be accusing me of nothing.
Well, that's not technically true. If you're poking around the car, you could have taken something.
Tell me about the car they were driving.
It was an old Ford. I didn't catch the license number.
Yeah. Sure, we'll go with it.
You look like the kind of guy who notices details.
You're right there. The car was old, but it looked brand new. Candy apple red paint job stands out a mile.
I'm sure it would. That's a fairly fancy looking car, I'm sure.
What exactly did you see them take?
They was working on the tires. That's all that was took.
And there's that I'm bullshitting your face again. Very nice, sir.
Right. So what did you take, Jacobs? Do you want my partner to pat you down?
I found a notebook in the glove compartment. I was gonna show you. It's on the chair on my porch.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Jacobs. You can speak to Officer Thibault about signing a formal statement.
When you get the car out of the way, maybe you could come back and do something about those kids.
Well, how about we bring you an umpire's mask?
Yeah, kids playing stickball in the backyard is not typically police jurisdiction. He said that he was going to mention the notebook to you, but unless you catch him on that last kind of lie that he was telling, you can completely miss this and not even know that it was here very easily. In fact, I did that the first time I played this. Aha, that sounds like a very Argentinian name.
Okay, so we have the owner of the vehicle, a degenerate. I'll run John Madsen by R&I.
Yep, so this gentleman apparently likes to collect the physical trait he likes the most about various males.
Contact details on a William Dewey. This looks like business rather than pleasure.
Mm-hmm. Also on that page is Gabriel, who he apparently met after William Dewey. That might be relevant later. And once again, we get the Dewey guy. His name comes up once again. His name was on the wrench.
I think we've run this place dry. Let's find a game well.
I can handle it, dude. So his name appeared on the wrench. His name appears in this book. So he obviously has some connection to this.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Could you run the name Dewey Brothers? Possibly a dealership or car mechanics workshop?
One moment. Dewey Brothers Packard Dealership, 629 Figueroa Street.
Got it. Can you put me through to Michigan 2458, please?
Connecting you now.
Hello, can I help you?
LAPD, ma'am. Can I speak to John Madsen, please?
He's at school, officer. What's this about? Is he in trouble?
How old is your boy, ma'am?
Just turned 16.
Wrong person, Mrs. Madsen. Sorry to disturb you.
Messages for me, please.
There's just one message for you, Detective. A four-door Packard, diplomatic license number Paul Robert 706, was reported missing this morning by Juan Francisco Valdez.
Could you have him brought in?
He's already here at Central, Detective. He's demanding an audience, as he calls it.
Thanks. Can you get a message to Captain Leary? Tell him we'll be in as soon as we can. Thanks.
All right, well, we can't have a diplomat waiting at the police station.
Can you cordon off this lot until we have the vehicle impounded?
Yes, sir, Detective.
We'll follow up on the owner. Get a statement from Jacobs, and I'll read your report back at the station.
Yeah, do my work. Do my bidding.
We can visit the Packard dealership or head back to Central and interview this Valdez character. Your call.
Well, we can't keep a diplomat from South America waiting now, can we?
Is someone going to tell us what the hell is going on?
Also, as that phone conversation with Mrs. Madsen told us, apparently he is not only having some nice affairs with males, but...
This has got to be the 50th abandoned vehicle call we have caught this year. One more and I'm going to go crazy. Not your favorite cases? You kidding me? This is barely even police work. Of all the bad guys in this city, we get lumped with the ones who can't even be bothered to keep what they steal.
Yeah, but apparently Mr. Valdez is having his affairs with underage boys, so that's great. I'm sure our captain, with his fire and brimstone and religious justice, will be happy.
Juan Francisco Valdez in for questioning. Sure do, Phelps. Your bird's an interview, too. And get this, he's wearing gloves and doing his best not to touch anything. Can you beat that? Sounds like we don't want to keep this guy waiting. It's this way.
I thought we would have a conversation with the captain here, but maybe that's later.
Straight through
about
the red
time. Are you the senior officer I requested?
I'm Detective Phelps, and this is Detective Bukowski.
Have you any idea how long I've been waiting to speak with you? I am needed back at the consulate, and you keep me here like a common criminal.
All right, friend. Let's take a deep breath and start all over again. Mr. Valdez.
Consul General. I insist on my full title.
See, he's not a common criminal. He has a special title and everything. He's an extra special criminal. Yeah.
Where did you purchase the car?
My secretary and driver arranged the purchase. A disreputable place, a Dewey Brothers by name. As soon as I can have it arranged, I will have my Hispano-Suiza brought up from Buenos Aires.
So, like, am I supposed to be impressed with that car name? I don't care about your stupid knockoff South American car, sir. And he's obviously hiding something, but I don't really think we can say he's lying yet.
Bought a Packard, Valdez. A snob like you doesn't drive an American car. I want answers or I'll smack you around the teeth.
William Dewey offered me a substantial bribe to make a purchase at his establishment. It is not unusual to make this kind of transaction in the civil service.
Don't tell that to the Argentine taxpayers.
Do you really care that much about the Argentinian taxpayer money? Is that really, you know, whatever?
Consul General, we have located your car. Can you tell us how it was stolen?
It must have been stolen from the consul garage. Terribly inconvenient, of course. I want the perpetrator soundly flogged.
Unfortunately, we don't do that here, Your Worship.
That's what I was going to say, Bukowski. I don't know. He's kind of shifty here.
You have a pretty good idea who stole the car, don't you, Consul General? Are you going to tell me, or do I shake it out of you?
There's no call for violence. I suspect a disgruntled boy from the car dealership.
You have a name for this kid?
Gabriel, like the Archangel. I have no surname.
Now let's talk about Gabriel. We have that little notebook that had his name in it.
So tell us about this kid, Gabriel. You had a run-in with him?
Mecanico. A presumptuous young man who did not know his place. He presumed to ask me questions.
We do a lot of presuming here in the United States, Consul General. It comes with the turf.
And he's really uneasy about this, and obviously he's not being truthful with us.
You fuck young boys, Valdez.
Are you a madman? This will cause an international incident.
Wow, I forgot how direct Cole Phelps was. That's amazing. Oh, woof.
Danny, Ben, Miguel, Tristan, and Teddy. Full lips. Ring any bells?
I'm sure we can come to some arrangement.
Gabriel, spill it.
A beautiful but impertinent boy. I mentioned rendezvous and the young man went quite insane. I thought he was going to kill me. I was prepared to pay.
We'll be in touch, Consul General.
Jesus, he's prepared to pay. I mean, what's the problem, right? I mean, what the heck? Cole Phelps also seems to have... Oh.
Finished with Valdez.
Thank God. I'll get rid of him. In a couple of hours.
Yeah, just make him wait here. He'll feel uncomfortable. It'll be great. No, but I forgot that... what was I saying? I was saying something that was very important to know. It was a very important know. Oh yeah, Cole Phelps seems to have issues with saying Spanish words or names. He called that guy, what was it, Miguel or something like that, and then that one lady from the last thing, he can say the Galleta, he said Galleta. I don't think he quite knows what he's doing, and the game did not give me a destination option here, so I'll have to do it manually. Usually that's really weird. Usually the game will, if you don't have a destination chosen, we'll automatically ask you to choose a destination when you get in the car.
Mr. Valdez moves in some peculiar circles for an international bon vivant.
Ah, English, please. See, this is why nobody invites you out for drinks.
It's just very industrious of him to be so involved in matters of consular transportation.
All right, you're making it worse now. I think what you're trying to say is that lover boy in there is as full of crap as a Christmas goose.
That as well.
Do you... This is when the, okay, this is one of the side missions that you can choose to take. I'm gonna choose not to take it.
Oh, man.
The light was great for you, jerko. Anyway, I just can't drive tonight. I don't know what's going on with me. I don't know. This whole driving a car thing, watching the road, talking, doing all that. I can't handle those guys. Oh my god.
Let me guess. You were making your way past the lot, caught sight of the new model four-door, and couldn't help yourself. You could see yourself in that car and just had to take a closer look. Well, I can't say as I blame you.
LAPD, Mac. We'd like to speak with the owner.
That's me, William Dewey, proprietor, at your service.
We're investigating the theft of a Packard belonging to the Argentine embassy. Are you missing a combination wrench?
I don't know, Detective. But I know how we can find out. Follow me.
Well, all right. You're being very helpful. I appreciate it very much, sir. Someone's about to hit somebody else, apparently. Yeah, any big city.
We keep all our tools in here.
Mind if we look around?
Be my guest.
Yeah, the only relevant clue here.
You sure you guys aren't interested in a new car? Huh? Maybe a used car.
Shut up.
I have some nice used cars for guys your wage bracket. I don't need your car. Shut up.
Okay.
Why don't you give us some alone time, Dewey? Go sell some cars or whatever it is that you do here.
That's not right.
Okay, calm down. There's lots of clues in this garage, but this is the only one that's relevant. And if I'm remembering correctly. Yep. Let's get us some good old color coding wrenches. Since the wrench that we found at the crime scene had red on it, it's obviously one of Gabriel's wrenches, but we still have to...
One left.
We still have to do this, even though.
Gabriel Delgado is missing a three-quarter.
Yeah, and we found a three-quarter at the crime scene that had red on it, so it was obviously... I don't know why we did that puzzle there, Cole. Okay, that's not useful. Thought that that was the only clue, but the game is indicating that it's not. Okay, so I finally gave up and blew an intuition point because I cannot for the life of me figure out what I was missing. It's license plates?
No good. We need diplomatic plates.
Yeah, no, that's why I didn't look at them. Oh, really? We need the... Okay, we had to check that out even though it was completely irrelevant. That's bizarre. I did not know. Anyway, yeah, that was a good showing at least. Yeah, that's what I was doing. I was showing off intuition points. You can spend intuition points to show all clues in the area in case you don't know where they're at.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
Look at that grin. Oh my god. Don't trust anyone who smiles like that, people. I'm gonna let you know that right now.
Packards are great cars, but this doesn't look like the kind of place favored by foreign embassies. How do you know Valdez?
I don't know Valdez. The embassy bought the car. All I know is he must know a quality car when he sees one.
Yeah, that's obviously not true.
And I know a shyster when I see one. You and Valdez are in this together.
Me and Valdez? I hardly know him. Valdez wouldn't wipe his shoes with me.
Oh, yeah? Then why does he have your information in his little book of... Wait, he has his... He has Dewey's information in his book of young boys he likes to sleep with. Does that mean him and Dewey, like...
We found your contact details in Valdez's notebook. He had to be calling you for something, Dewey.
Okay. So I met Valdez in a bar. We cut a deal. He bought the car through the embassy. I cut him some change on the side. It happens all the time.
The sad thing is, that's probably true.
Where can we find Delgado?
I don't know. He sure as hell isn't here.
Really? You expect me to believe that you employ someone and you have no contact information for them at all? Yeah, that's not true.
Address, Dewey, or my partner shoves your head in a car door.
Okay, all right. Apartment 3103 Hill Street. And tell him from me. If he ever shows his face around here again, I'm gonna kick his butt from here to Kingdom Come.
Okay, cool. Was that a thing you could do back then? Like, really? I know, I'm pretty sure cops can't do that now, but could you really just threaten physical violence on people if they wouldn't tell you what you wanted to know? In the 40s, I'm not sure that was standard police procedure.
A wrench from this dealership was used to strip the wheels from a Packard last night, Mr. Dewey. A couple of Hispanics were seen taking parts.
We've had a spate of thefts ourselves. Comes with the location. Thieving bastards to steal anything the minute your back is turned.
I don't know. He seems kinda... Let's use some intuition. Well, we obviously can't accuse him of lying because we don't have anything that would point to him lying, but we can doubt him at least.
What are you hiding, Dewey? Spill it! You don't want the LAPD getting too interested in this place.
So I hire a few illegals. It's cheaper than hiring returning GIs. They have less attitude. Downside is, they're a little light-fingered.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Dewey.
No problem. God damn that kid. I'm just an honest car salesman. Seems like you just don't know who you can trust these days.
Going to movies, Dewey. You're missing your calling. Time to visit Gabriel Delgado. See how good his excuse is.
I do like that he talks about people being untrustworthy when he basically tried to lie his way through that entire interrogation for no real reason. Outside of him doing a little bit of bribery on the side to get people to buy cars from him, but... Oh, chill out, guys. Yeah, if you live in a big city, people honking their horns at each other is pretty much a non-stop thing.
You read this story in the Examiner about the Navy developing three-dimensional movies? What's a dimension? You know, like a graph. Vertical axis is Y and horizontal is X. Well, that's clear as mud. Third dimension would be Z. So things would be popping out of the screen. That's ridiculous. Scare people out of the theater. God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talking in color. Look what we have now.
As it turns out, Bukowski is completely correct about 3D. 3D is an abomination to movie-going experience.
INS officer needs help, 333 South Main Street. 333 South Main Street,
that whole conversation, though, was reminded me greatly of when I was in college studying to get my math degree, when I was trying to explain what I was studying to my family or non-math inclined friends, trying to explain how they determine probabilistic outcomes for systems and things like that, or trying to explain to them how to do high-end physics, theoretical physics, and quantum mechanics, and they do not follow the conversation particularly well, but that's okay. That's not stuff that really is vital information for your survival. We had to park out front here. I forgot.
Okay, let's see what Gabriel has to say for himself.
I just hope our Archangel hasn't already flown.
Unfortunately, that is the case. Well,
isn't he the cop that we're talking about on the radio? Want another comedy?
They didn't say. I thought they might say something interesting, but they didn't. That's unfortunate. Where is the nice listing of apartments? There we are. Mail that will tell us at least. 3.
Here he is. Apartment 3.
Very good work. Our master detective, Cole Phelps. And here we are.
Yet?
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Gabriel Delgado.
Gabriel?
We're from the police. Policia, you understand?
Yes, I understand. Could you come inside?
What is your name?
Ana Rodriguez.
Is Gabriel Delgado here, Ms. Rodriguez?
No. What do you want with Gabriel? Is he in trouble?
Stay where you are, Ms. Rodriguez. We need to take a look around.
But he is not here. I have told you.
Check out the surrounds. I'll stay with the broad.
Yeah, we're not going to take your word for it.
So how
especially
far
with this
along are you?
No, on a table. Look at this.
Nearly 20 weeks.
Souvenirs are a dumb move.
Right.
True.
So how's it going to be when you go into labor and he's not around?
The Bible.
You are wrong.
The Bible has all the
Gabriel.
Answers.
He will be a good father.
Well, maybe
already
not for this case.
He works hard to provide for us.
Unless you help us here, Anna, your little one won't be seeing Papa for a very long time.
It's true. You tell her. You tell her, man. She has to know what kind of situation she's in. Here's that four that we heard so much about at the beginning of the game. I mean, the mission.
Difficult to tell whether it's the suspect vehicle from the scene. Certainly Gabriel's pride and joy.
I'm pretty sure it is. There's no color of that picture, but it's pretty easy to tell.
Incidental.
Oh, I thought... That one always gets me. Every time I play this mission, that one always makes me wonder and think that it's actually important when it's not.
Probably nothing.
And this too. There's another mission later where something like that will be important. However, and here is the real important stuff.
Serving breakfast for two, Anna? You should have cleared up.
Yeah, I've heard of eating for two when you're pregnant, however, I didn't know that you were supposed to sit at both ends of the table and eat off different plates. We should probably get a teapot off of the kettle. Get the kettle off of the stove before it blows us all up. Also, this mission's kind of tricky-ish. This is one of the very, very rare missions where you have to explore far away from the house that you're in order to get all the pieces of evidence. In fact, most of the evidence is not in the house itself. It's out here. Like this one. Hey, that license plate looks familiar.
Diplomatic license plates.
And it just so happens to be the license plate number of the Packard. Who would have thunk? I don't believe any of this is relevant. However... Okay, stop. Oh my god, that's not what I wanted. I wanted these. Looky there.
It looks like Valdez gets his wheel back.
Gets two wheels back, in fact. I guess he must have stole the spare and the main tire. Anyway, as the music was so kind to point out to us, we are done. And that was a... Anyone see that glitch? There was a glitch there. What was that? Like a ghost attacked me or something. Well, sorry. Anyway, let's go talk to Miss, Miss, what was her name? I don't know her name.
You're in serious trouble, Miss Rodriguez.
But Gabriel is not here. I have done nothing wrong.
I thought her name was Miss Rodriguez, but I didn't want to sound like... I thought all Hispanic people were named Rodriguez. So I didn't say it. I should have just went with it. Oh.
Why did he steal the car, Anna?
The customer insulted him. He has his honor, no?
Don't you eye me, woman. Look at you. She's staring us down. What? I don't think that's a lie. Wait, what am I doing? That's not a lie. That can't be a lie.
His honor, Anna?
He said Dewey's friend tried to make a woman out of him. He no longer respects this man, Dewey. He took the car to show this maricón that he is a man.
Honor and manhood, I don't know. I don't get the point.
Tell us the truth, Anna. Has Gabriel been here?
I haven't seen him for at least 3 nights.
Oh, that's an incredibly obvious lie.
You keep lying to me, and I'll send you and your baby to jail.
He lives here, but he hasn't come home. I swear it.
Well, it looks like you and your baby are going to jail, then. In fact, if you have your baby in jail, they'll go to Child Protective Services. And then that'll be fun for you to try and get back.
Enough, Anna. There are signs all over this place that he's been back.
He was here last night. I have never seen him so angry. He went out to his shed and put some things in it. I don't know what, and I don't want to know. I love him.
See, so the game's not completely heartless. It does mention that there were things out in the shed to go look at. I don't think that you need them in order to interrogate her, so they're not incredibly vital, but you do want to find them before you leave.
We found a license plate matching our stolen vehicle in the shed. Add in the assortment of parts, and we can make Gabriel for a dozen other thefts. It's time to get serious, Anna.
You must ask these questions of Gabriel. I know nothing of these car parts.
And the game proves me wrong immediately by making sure that you know that this question would not have been asked if you did not go out to the shed. I am so dumb. I don't know, She's acting really fidgety and uppity and overly defensive about this, so let's go with doubt. Yeah, we'll doubt her.
Then tell us where he is! If your baby is born in prison, Anna, the corrections officers will take it from you. You will see your son or daughter through a metal grate for half an hour a week.
The start line is on 1st and Santa Fe. There is a spillway under the bridge that leads to the river. Many policia have wrecked trying to follow him.
We will put in a good word for you, Anna. As far as we're concerned, this sits with Gabriel.
Start line? That sounds like a street race to me. It's gotten out of hand this last year. No wonder Delgado has such an eye for fine automobiles.
We know where the kid is. Let's go stop these clowns and get him off the streets.
Chill out, dude. I just want to say something, please.
Isn't he the cop they've been talking about on the radio?
Yeah, so as we will soon find out, apparently the police in the city have no driving skills whatsoever. But that's okay. Let's take some off-road.
What kind of man leaves his pregnant girlfriend at home while he...
Take it easy!
Oh, sorry to interrupt you. What were you saying, Cole?
Pregnant girlfriends aren't always a barrel of laughs. Everyone used to let off a little steam. Some guys wouldn't come back home at all.
Are you talking from experience?
Ooh, that's a little bit...
Quick as we shut one of these races down, another one springs up somewhere else. Kids used to steal cars to sell them. Now they just want to wrap them around a lamppost. The next 16-year-old I have to peel off the sidewalk, you're calling the mother. I've had enough of those to last me a lifetime.
Yep, hot rodding is no good, people. Not trying to act like you're a badass. Also, we should probably have our siren on so cars will get out of the way. That would be probably a good idea. Pull over. Yeah, there you go. The last guy didn't pull over. It's a violation of the rules. Woo! Why?
Suspect vehicles engaged in illegal street Nothing.
Yep.
Units to him, code 3, identify.
We're already on our way, sir.
There's the red Ford. That's Delgado right there.
Quick! They're getting away!
Phelps, 1247, requesting assistance at 1st and Santa Fe. Reports of an illegal street force.
They already contacted Sabella, say no.
Stay on Delgado.
Oh man, watch it, buddy. We're not part of the race.
Get in the way!
We're not part of the race, get away from us. Jesus. Oh shit, stop. I don't remember them.
Step on
I don't remember them being not so aggressive on this.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on! Delgado is our boy, forget the others.
I would if they stopped running into me. No, we're not. Now it's just us and him. Everybody else crashed into the police thing. But if you'll notice, driving through here, there's lots of other vehicles in here. Like, watch, see, like that there? Bunch of other vehicles up here. These are presumably the other police who tried to chase him down here and wrecked.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on!
Oh, I thought I'd get him. Yeah, he's gonna try and get up here in a second, I promise. Man, I'm not doing so great.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy
out. I'm trying.
Out.
My car won't go any faster, I swear.
God damn it, Cole, hold it steady.
Okay, sure, I will.
Come on,
and there you go. Car is completely ruined, but we stopped him. Hey.
Gabriel Delgado, you're under arrest for Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck you, puto! You just speak to the maricón! Valdez, I showed him! Now who's a man? I should've burned his fucking car!
Yeah, now you're a man in jail, so good for you, I guess.
You got a foreign dignitary outed as a fruit and a kitty raper, a car dealer we're gonna let slide for the kickbacks, and a street punk car thief who sure as hell won't be taking liberties with other people's autos again anytime soon. That Detective Phelps is not a bad haul. You keep your chin low and your hands high, and you keep bringing me clearances just like that one. That's textbook policing, and we need more of it in this department.
Yeah, Bukowski, why don't you stop sucking and do your job to help me out a little bit here. You're worthless. You're just a worthless weight tied around my neck, man. Fuck. Bukowski. It's also worth noting, I suppose, that during the street race, any damage done to you and the other vehicles does not count towards this damage total. However, if you run people over or destroy street lamps and such, you will get fined for that still. So no murdering people with your car for no reason while you're driving in that race. And the Argentinian Consul General, he got his car back. However, now everyone kind of knows about his extracurricular activities. Anyway, that's this mission done. I thank you all for joining me, and I will see you next time.
Do you have any plans for weekend Liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before Liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection! It had better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. 2-day field drill. Oh, man. clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished? Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Yes, as the game told us earlier, during the opening narrations, Mr. Jack Kelso is not so good at backing down from a fight, even when he should probably not even start in the first place. I forgot completely that that was going to play here. Usually, if you don't have that DLC, it plays at a different time. And I forgot that some of the DLC missions play a clip afterwards, and some of them don't. So, that was one of the ones I do. Now that's it. Now that's all done. Next time we'll be doing this mission at Ray's Cafe. And I'll see you then. For real this time. I promise.